Welcome to the last part of the property management service company setup. The most important result of all your accounting work will be the property management reports and statements. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. What information is on property management reports? Well, a property management company is a typical company. So, of course, you will have the typical accounting reports, such as the profit and loss and the trial balance. But property management companies need another report. A report that shows how much each landlord client will receive at the end of the month. That's the most important report. That report should show, first, how much you collected from each client. It should show how much you are withholding from the client's payout for expenses that you paid on behalf of the client. And it should show how much you withheld from the client's payout for the management service fees that you charge them. The net that you owe for each tenant's collections and the total you owe to that landlord for the month should also be summarized clearly on that main report. How are we going to set that up? Well, first, we'll set up the general reports. And you will see basic report customization. And we will save the reports in the icon bar, which means you'll get a little crash course in managing the icon bar. The reports we use and we modify and memorize are the trial balance, the journal, and the customer balance detail. So let's set those up first, or at least let's set up these first two, because these first two we would set up for any company because they're general financial information. If we are going to use the icon bar for shortcuts for our reports and transactions, it's better to move the icon bar to the top. Click View and click Top Icon Bar. Now you notice that all these little shortcuts are things that we have not used and might not use, such as the statement writer or any other kind of feature that they put up as shortcuts. So what we will do is customize the icon bar and remove the shortcuts that we don't need and put up the shortcuts that we do need. View, Customize Icon Bar. Now you have the Customize Icon Bar window. Click here and notice these choices here correspond to each icon. If you click Delete, 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 you will see that they will all disappear if you keep clicking Delete. You must click OK because if you click Cancel, they'll come back. View, Customize Icon Bar, and after you made the change to the icon bar, you must click OK, because if you click Cancel, it won't save the changes to the icon bar. Now we'll open up the main financial report. Reports, Accountant and Taxes, Trial Balance. Now, the trial balance is the main report because it shows the results of all accounts, all accumulated totals of all accounts in the chart of accounts. But we don't want to limit it to 1 month. We're going to modify this report by clicking the date pull down and scrolling all the way up to the very top option. Click all. We want our trial balance to show the results of all transactions regardless of date. And we want the text to be a little bigger. So we click the Customize Report button in the top left. Then you can click header footer, and you can actually, excuse me, fonts and numbers, change font, and then change it to 12 and click OK. Yes. Click OK in the main modify window. Now you'll be able to see, you might even want to stretch this column a little bigger. Now we're able to see everything much better. And now that the report looks the way we need it to look with the right date and the right size letters, we will save it to the icon bar. Very simple. Click View, and the active window will show up in this choice list. Add trial balance to the icon bar, click it, and then click OK. We can close the trial balance. Now notice it's asking, should we memorize this report? The answer is no. We click here and click no. Now, if we click right on the icon bar, you see it opens exactly the way we left it off. If we go all the way back to the main menu and start from the beginning, it opens the way it looked originally. So it's nicer to memorize it and save it in the icon bar so we don't have to change the customization each time. Now, let's open up the journal. Reports, Accountant and Taxes, Journal. Click OK. Now, again, we want to see the results of all transactions regardless of date. However, the journal we're going to modify differently. The journal is a list of every transaction that was ever recorded in the file, and it makes it very easy to find everything. However, these are not the columns we want. We want to remove the columns that we don't need, and we want to put the columns that we do need. Click Customize Report, and in the Display tab, this is what we do. Click here to add a column entered last modified. Click OK, and now you can see that in addition to the date of the transaction, we now have a column that will show us the date that it was entered or last modified. And that will be very, very helpful when we're finding and fixing mistakes. We can get rid of a column by moving to the three dots to the right until the mouse becomes a cross. Click drag over the column to the left, and that column will disappear. We can make a column bigger by moving the mouse to the three dots until it becomes an X. Click and drag to the right, it will become bigger. Account name, click and drag to the right. Memo, click and drag to the right. You can even increase this width. Now, I don't want a debit and credit column. I want one column for amount. So I click Customize icon bar, scroll down, remove the check mark next to debit and credit just by clicking, and then click Amount, so that debit and credit are replaced by amount. And this is the best way to have your journal look before you start searching for transactions whenever you need to find and fix mistakes. Click View, and then click Add Journal to the icon bar, and click OK. Now we have our two main financial reports, and if we open them from the icon bar, they look the way they looked when we memorized them. But if you start fresh from the main menu, they'll look the way they looked originally. So now you can see the basic ideas behind customizing reports, and you can see the basic ideas behind customizing the icon bar. But the main and most important report that we use is the customer balance detail. The customer balance detail is the main report that we use, and we will modify it and customize it so that the title reads Landlord Payout Balance. We will see how to customize the report title and change the text in the icon bar. And I have other tutorials that go a little deeper into report customization and go a little deeper into learning how to manage the icon bar. But you can see you really don't need it. Those are two very simple and intuitive ideas. And you can explore and experiment with customized icon bar later if you want to get more fancy. But right now, again, we want to call it the Landlord Payout Balance Report. So how do we do that? From the main menu, we click Reports, Customers and Receivables, Customer Balance Detail. Now, I like to make the account column a little wider, and you'll see why that's helpful later. But to customize this report, we go to the top left and we click Customize Report. Click the header footer tab and change the report title to Landlord Payout Balances, and then we click OK. So now the title more clearly explains how our company is going to use it. And the last change we will make, we will add the memo field, which you will see later is the most important field. We click Customize Report and make sure the Display tab is selected and scroll down to where it says Memo. Click OK. Make sure the memo field is wide enough by moving the mouse to the three dots to the right of the word memo and click and drag, maybe a little more. And now that the report looks the way we need it to look, we will click View, Add Customer Balance Detail to the icon bar. Now, if you want the text of the icon bar to be the same as the text in the title, you can click where it says Label and type in the same words. After you click OK, now you have the three most common reports and the most important report in the icon bar. And finally, to save time, let's add the three more windows that we will use the most often as a property management company: the Create Invoice window, the Write Checks window, and the Receive Payment window. From the main menu, click View, Customize Icon Bar. Now let's add three separators between the three important reports and the three most important transaction windows. Add separator, add separator, add separator, and click OK. Now let's add the invoice window. Click Customers, Create Invoice, and at the moment the invoice is the active window, click View, Add Create Invoice to the icon bar, and click OK. Now let's add the checks window. Click Banking, Write a Check. At the moment that's the active window, click View, Add Write Checks to the icon bar, and click OK. And lastly, let's add the Receive Payment window. Click Customers, Receive Payment. And then we click View, Add Receive Payments to the icon bar, and click OK. Now we have the three most important reports and the three most common transactions and 90% of your activities in a property management service company when recording everything in QuickBooks will be with these six icons. Very simple. Congratulations, you're all set up and ready to make your first transaction, which will be shown in the very next video.